Who's there?
Frederick Glumpson, we are your worst nightmare. We are the victims of your selfishness and gluttony. The cumulative wrongs and misdeeds of a lifetime come home to roost at last. Beware, Frederick. Be very aware.
No, no,
we are the tortured specters of every innocent pizza you have ever eaten.
No! Spirits be gone, please! Leave me be!
No! The time has come for you to answer for your crimes, Mr. Glumpson. The souls of countless pizza pies cry out for vengeance, and so you shall know our torment.
Wait, wait. Pizzas don't have souls.
Burn! Oh! Heartless knave! If you overcook us, do we not burn? If you leave us out for a week, do we not develop mold? If you slice us, do we not bleed marinara?
I'm so confused.
Good! Now cower before this carefully prepared parade of your victims. It was very difficult to settle upon the order in which we would introduce ourselves to you with maximum impact, much like the arrangement of a good party mix or poetry anthology. So pay attention!
Ooh, I'm the slice of New York style pie you picked up at the food court in the mall the day Jenny broke up with you. You got my crust all soggy with your pansy tears, and you didn't even fold me in half when you chowed me down. Not folding the pizza like a sandwich ought to be a crime, you lousy pig.
I was heartbroken. I didn't know what I was doing.
Silence! Take a good look, kid. Do I look familiar? I'm the Chicago deep dish you boxed up and forgot at the restaurant there. Why, do you take me for a salad? I could have fed you for days there.
You gotta believe me. I was so bummed when I realized I'd left you behind. I didn't mean
quiet! It's a me, the gourmet classic Italiano style margarita you ordered at that trendy, expensive restaurant downtown, remember? You were all weirded out when you realized that a real pizza is nothing but a slab of bread with a little bit of cheese and a slice of tomato on the top. You threw me away without even finishing even one pizza.
Watch it, pal!
Hey, you treat our ancestor with respect there!
Heretic!
Grand dessert pizza!
Who
you're just a big cookie
dessert
with
pizza?
Stuff on it. That ain't pizza.
Enough! Frederick Glumpson. Your crimes have been recapitulated in dramatic fashion. Now, what have you to say for yourself? How do you plead?
Well, to be honest, okay, look, I'm really sorry if I hurt you. I'm sorry if I disrespected the nobility and understated the dignity of your kind. But I plead not guilty.
Mamma mia!
I plead not guilty, because the only thing I am guilty of is loving you. I love pizza. New York style. I love your can-do attitude and city pride. And the way one slice of you is as big as my head.
Go on.
And deep dish. I love your, shucks, Midwestern demeanor. And the way you're really a dense cake of cheese and meat. You're great.
Jeez, I'm blushing over here.
And traditional. Well, sure, I don't really even understand how you can technically be called a pizza, but without you, I wouldn't have any of the delicious, greasy, dripping circles that I've come to cherish and treasure over a lifetime of eating.
Well, it's a true.
So no, Pizza Tribunal, I'm not guilty. And if loving pizza more than anything, including your friends and family, is a crime, will it lock me up?
Appreciation, we will leave behind a permanent scent of garlic sauce in your bedroom.
Oh, well, actually, this is my brother's room. Mine's being fumigated.
The Pizza Ghost Tribunal has spoken!